the track tonight. Let's get a welcome to the St. Louis, Missouri Hard Driver Roller Derby, the Old New England. Number 13, Bloody Gaga. 5'3"8, Boomer Yang. Number 6, Bruce Almighty.
And the Sam will run The sand will run down, and on one side is a picture of Cardi jamming like the badass that she is, and then on the other side is her army picture being a badass as well. So at each practice, we will turn this over and watch the sand drop and remind us that you will be coming back, okay? Poster for you to let you know that we'll miss you. So go on here, lay the smack down, show them what you're made of, and let's be famous.
Well, welcome one and all, Wheels of Wonder. We're getting ready to get this thing going. Things are coming out. Once again, it is our tribal versus your NRD team. So uppers, the Fleur Delinquents facing off against the Warning Bells. Do we have any St. Louis fans here now? Anybody tribal? All right. Where are our Naptown fans at tonight? For the whistle, and we're gonna get this going. There we are, the first whistle blows, and we are at the races, so to speak. It looks like the Warning Bells have broken through first. And Harvis is your lead champ. Harvis getting all 4 points. And it looks like the Warning Bells were able to shut out the Delinquents that damn 8-0. I want to say real quick thanks to BCG and Britain signage that doesn't suck by from BCG. And next up at the Fox 59 dinner line, Bill. Four-stoke, diving in the back, falling right off. 0 points on that pass. A total of four for the total game. We are scoring 12-4 right now. Still in favor of the Warning Bell.
That is good people, McAllister Machinery, Brad Thompson, RD.
Also to Paul Coleman, the Rock and Roll Family Doc, located in the Broadbrook area and available for all your dentistry needs. Check them out at ColemanDental.com. You know, Bill, I'm looking over there. I can see the state rental public house situation serving Great Devil beer. I'm pretty sure that we will not run out of beer this time. Fingers crossed. Action is back on track here. Wheels of Wonder. Bloody Gaga, Jamie, and St. Louis. But it's going to be the Warning Bells. Sergeant Slaughter. Lead Jammer Sides. Looks like Sergeant Slaughter's going to head to the penalty box. Serve some time. That's going to be situation. Bloody Gaga trying to make up some of those lost points in the first couple of games, Bill. Well, you are 4 points already up on the board all alone out there on the track. Well, not basically all alone, but a little spin move gets her out in front of her back in another 4 points going up, bringing us to a tie about right now. But the score is still happening as we speak. Over here in turn three, we got it holding the pile. Defense is starting to get strong, holding St. Louis at bay. They want to get through that inside track. Once again, doing a good job and holding her in the back. She is picking her way through that pack. And out she goes. Another 4 points up on the board for the Blue River Lancers. Sergeant Slaughter going back and play. He had already put 4 points up on the board. That last half is going to be another 4 points. Right now, it's up that time for a total of 12 on this half. And the Florida Lakers also has 12 points in this game. For 24-16, the game comes to an end. Florida Lakers put a couple more 4 points on the board. It's 26-20 right now. Warning Bells holding on to that lead by 6.
Right, you are, Bill.
Nope. I realize sometimes we have, but we still have some new fans who may not be familiar with what the heck is going on out there. So we'll try to do our best as the game goes on to kind of explain the ins and outs. Kind of teach the best of the game. If you know somebody close to you that may be a dirty fan, the first jammer to break the pack in this case, Stevie Nicks, through the league, the lead jammer says, that gives that jammer the ability to call off the jam, which sometimes is a strategic position to be in. Harness, out for the Warning Bells, puts a few points on the board. And we sit at 30-24. So, if you're a new fan, what you're going to see here is you're going to have a skating with a Fox 59 jammer on right now. And you've got the two skaters in the back with stars on their helmet. Those are the jammers. Those are the ones that can score. The rest of everybody else is what's known as the pack. Now when the whistle blows, everybody goes. Now the first pass to the pack, the jammers are just starting to establish who in this there will be a lead jammer. Sometimes that happens fast, sometimes slow. On this side, boom! Number 602, Storm Gunn, is the lead champion in control of the Warning Bells of this game. Now, once that jammer has made it to the pack one time, every other time they pass to the pack, they get 1 point for each opposing player they pass leading. Now, you might be asking yourself, why would you call off the jam? How don't they just keep skating, keep racking up those points? Well, sometimes you want to get in there and score 4 points and keep the other team from scoring points at all. And that's the game. That's the end of the game. That's why it's a game sometimes to own that lead jammer stat. So that's a great explanation, Brian. I think I got it. the Mach 59 general line with License to Kill from that town. The whistle has been blown. License to Kill has blown through that pack, and she is the lead jammer for that pack. Folks up to a little hang outside of turn two. License to Kill easing her way through that pack. There's 4 points going up on the board for that pack. License to Kill walks to the outside. Starts to reach back and looks back, sees the oncoming jammer, falls off the jam. That puts that time score at 38 and 4-0 for 24.
Slow, since you think our friends are spreading through coffee.com. It's special games for every event. Best roasted coffee with a loose shop or online at goodcoffee.com. Buddy Guy Brown is coming on right now. Sergeant Slaughter at the Fox 69 gang line. Buddy Guy Brown heads on the back. Sergeant Slaughter looking through the outside, doesn't find it. Both gangers right now struggling with the rear defense of that pack. Sergeant Slaughter breaks through first, and Sergeant Slaughter is your lead jammer. Sergeant Slaughter controls the ball at the game anytime. Supports the board right now, or thinking to. Hits the back of that pack with some force there. 33, we got enough for us. It looks like that's going to take us to 39 to 24. 7-3 to 1 to go. 20 minutes left to play in regulation time. And our first two halves in our first two backs. So.
Thank you.
through while simultaneously containing the opposing jammer. Well, that was such an interesting strategy.
I was thinking a bit of a pump there, 2-4, but Stacey and Pratt. Obviously, another round of points on the board, creating more of a point spread here on the NCAA line of scoreboard. Well, here we go, another 4 point goal up on the board for that time. 16 during the game so far, and it's still going on.
Being a little warning bell defense there.
And it's going to be enough to contain Arch Rival, giving Isis a kick. The brilliant strike that we can understand. One of those once again in control. Calling off the game after one quick pass through. I think that's going to be 4 points now. 87-28. 12 minutes of change left in our first two halves. In our first few bouts of the team. Thanks to our charitable sponsor tonight, Paul's and Smith, and our proper organization on focusing on the at-risk community, both here and in Canada. The business is www.paulsandsmith.org. And this is a good table here tonight. I heard rumors that there might actually be some service dogs in the building. I don't know for sure, Bill, but Ben's website heard it.
Well, here we go. We're talking about maybe trying to fight some service dogs. That time it was a league game challenge at his feet and has put 4 points up on the board. Well, here we go. It's time to try to put another 4 points on the board.
Sandstorm turn to one and turn to the school bench and the opening for another 4 points. Total 12 right now, 99-28. Will she get in there and break the 100 mark for that time? We'll see in just a few seconds. Wow, that was on a rock and roll knee slide. 4 points, another 4 points going up. That time breaks the 100, so they're 103. Right now, 28. Thank you. Sandstorm has done that. In the outside. Another 4 points going up. So we're 20 points right now in this game.
No, no.
And we've got 24 points. Ladies and gentlemen, Don Slaughter. Going to see the one thing about offensive showing 20 minutes of gameplay. Once again, I just want to say thanks to Daredevil Beer for being here tonight and bringing more beer this time. I don't think they're ready. Last time, really not a beer that we could drink here. Good old Southside Indy, Bill. Well, here we are, Harless off the back screen jammer. Do that back first on the outside. Harless is your lead jammer. How you gonna fall off the jammer anytime? Tell you right now, Bill, that pack's looking a little thin now in between turn one and two.
Well, I'm just coming out another 4 points right now. And the St. Louis defense is anxiously waiting to game up inside the track. Another 4 points going up.
Don't forget to visit the merch booth. Oh, that's a cool flag. There we go, calling it off. After squeezing out another 4 points, 12 points going up in this game, 123-28. Just under 9 minutes in the first half. It's amazing, though. You know, those guys have mentioned the merch booth. It's not only can you buy a bunch of cool logos and swag, you can also get involved and vote for your favorite state at least, right? Give your vote in, which is the fan favorite award, taking in the merch group, and donate towards your favorite state. We will announce the winner of the fan favorite award, and each top donation will help your halftime early meeting continue to bring you the sport you love and all halftime programs to help you get involved. Well, that sounds like only one thing. There is a lead jammer. Right now, that lead jammer is a warning bell. Armageddon in control. Stormageddon in control of the jammer. Now, Stormageddon will call up the jam at any time. Stormageddon blasting out of the pack there on the back stretch, taking a couple of hits on the way out. That don't mean that.
No!
Junction 38, Drive 638, Indianapolis Marriott East, where we have a fun and fandom including a Star Wars inspired rock band. Fantastic World to Wait! That is Indy Junction. July 6 to 8, Indianapolis Marriott East. Scoreboard has gone blue, folks. And correct me if I'm wrong, Bill. Blue is not a good color in the world, might be.
Yeah, correct. When the scoreboard gets the blue screen of death, the game comes to a halt. Speaking of halt, you know, Daredevil's got some beer over there to buy. And guess what? Tonight's Star Wars night. There's a bunch of Star Wars characters running around. We got a photo area over there. Thanks to the 501st for coming out and joining us and hanging out like they do on our Star Wars themed bouts. May the 4th be with you if you get what I'm saying. There we go. Hey, did we try turning it off and back on again?
Yeah.
there, Harless cut through for a fourth. Situation in favor of that time on that pass. Harless skipping through the inside. Another third point called off the jam. Only St. Louis.
Don't forget to visit the convention, 38, July 68, and that's your IDs. We're going to have fun in fandom. Also, if you want us to say something on the mic, like, I don't know, hey, happy birthday, or hey, congratulations on your wedding, or, you know, whatever it is, you can head on over to the merch booth and make a little donation. Either to our charity or to the league, we'd be happy to oblige for you.
Fans, and maybe some of old fans that don't know,
The pack is an area designated by the referees. Sometimes they hold their hands up to kind of bracket where the pack is. When a skater cannot be engaged or be engaged 20 feet in front of or behind that area. So if a blocker engages a jammer, too far outside the pack. So the pack just can't be spread out all over the track. The point is to keep the pack looks like we are officially at halftime, so I would encourage you now to maybe go get in line for some grab bag of beer, maybe visit the refreshment stand, the merch booth, or the fan favorite table, or the restroom, if that's what you need to do. But we've only got about 14 and a half minutes left, so do it. You get back in your seats.
GoPro, stop recording.
FTL's on three. Have Josie leave that off.
Really loud, right. Really scary, really loud.
Yeah. One, two, three.
FTL's!
trying to get through that serious defense.
through it. And she works it out. With NASCAR, I think he's running up on the board, holding St. Louis for the Z Road. Good job to Paul Cole, the Rock and Roll Family Dock, the Rock Dock, located in the Broadway area, available for all your dentistry needs. Check him out, ColeMcDental.com, that's Cole with a K. Thanks once again to our friends from Daredevil for providing beer for all of us here tonight. The lead grammar status of Sergeant Slaughter. He can throw with Sergeant Slaughter while you sip on your delicious Daredevil beer, which we'll hopefully have for the duration of the evening. Well, I keep bringing it up because it's just such a hard thing to take. But from what I understand, the beer's flow and the profit growth. Right now, the back stretch. The back is this good. There's a lot going on. And what I do know is this Sergeant Slaughter breaks three and puts another 4 points on the board before the warning bells. Sergeant Slaughter on the inside with a DCG Apex jump to put another round of points on the board. Our driver just not able to get a jammer through that practice pass. Don't try as they might. Sergeant Slaughter taking a hit at turn four, down and back up again. Through the pack, Sergeant Slaughter with another round of points on board for the warning bell. Less than 25 minutes left in gameplay for this top. 183 to 49. Warning bell. Sergeant Slaughter looking to strike the win. Art Driver finally in a position now. And here comes the change out. Doing really quick before I pass off to you. I would like to say thanks to our good friends at Strange Brew. StrangeBrewCoffee.com, fresh roasted coffee, available in shop and online. Get to some!
Alright, Harless, up against Harless Fist. Harless threw that back. She is the lead Gemma.
Keep pushing that out!
Harla Diamond calling it off. Getting out 2 points for Nat Town. I correct myself. 1 point for Nat Town, 2 points for St. Louis. Let me make that correction. So 188 to 52 right now, 23 minutes to change us in this first bout.
Thanks once again to Fox 59. News research for local news, weather, sports, and more. Check it out for Fox 59 and Hannah Live right now. We'll start this next game. And already, the warning bells are putting up these jammer statuses everywhere. So I'm again with another lead jammer status this bout. Facing off against Bloody Gaga, the Art Driver. Not giving Bloody Gaga an opportunity to score any points. Calling off the game for Art Driver to get into position. Don't forget to visit Infant Junction 38. Go out 6-8 at Indianapolis Marriott East. For a weekend of fun and fandom, including the Star Wars inspired rock band. Fantastic World to Win, bro.
I went to that convention, no lie. A couple years back, it was a lot of fun. and she is the lead.
You know, Bill, I just want to say what's up really quick. I was told that we had some Nighttown veterans in the crowd tonight, but we don't call them that here in Nighttown. We don't say veterans, Bill. We say Nighttown legends. And we had some Nighttown legends in the audience tonight. So, you know, wave your hand if you feel like maybe you may have been recognized if you're from one of our Nighttown legends. We'd like to just say, hey, what's up? Thanks for coming out. We hope we're doing well. Back on the track here at Wheels of Wonder off the Fox 59 general line. Lead jammer status once again goes out to the Warning Bells and once again gets awarded to Sergeant Slaughter. Stevie Nicks in the back of the pack being held up by a couple of brutal Warning Bell defenders. Sergeant Slaughter breaking free, putting 4 points on the board for the Warning Bells. We are at the 2-century mark now for the Warning Bells. It gets 52 points from the Fort Olympics. 20 with the blows, the team down happens. Hey, just a quick reminder, if you're in our Trackside City, also known as the Suicide City, you got to be 18 years old and sit there.
Child sitting in their parents' lap, they can't be there.
You can be 12 and sit in a parent's lap. You can't have it. You got to be 18 years old and sit in the Trackside City. We do apologize for the inconvenience, but it's a two-line road. So please don't sit there if you are 18 years old. If you do choose to sit there, you are releasing the lead and the running hall responsibilities and everything that may happen. And if it will happen, but if it does, we have the EMTs available to have that. Anyways. Number 34, Stoke, the Fox 69 Carolina, face off against number 602, Stormageddon. This is a matchup I've seen before here in the room. Here we go, the one whistle that rules them all. So McGee chooses the edge. It's outside, or in front, inside, who moves the outside to find room. Makes it happen. So McGee, your lead jammer. Warning Bells establishing offensive dominance early. in the city or public house. Beer Devil swing out some of the most delicious beer in the city of Minneapolis. Dylan and I are going to get some right now, and it comes highly recommended. Also, thanks once again to our NSOs, referees, and just volunteers in general for helping us put this together.
Don't forget to visit the fan favorite table and vote for your fan
favorite. He will be giving out awards here after this battle is over. About 12 minutes left to play, and congratulations. But that time is called a timeout. Quick announcement, as we can see Lanner at the announcer table, just so we get an opportunity. Lanner, if you can please come to the announcer table. Thank you so much.
Just immediately following the stop, 8 minutes and 8 minutes left to play here. soccer down. Nice defense.
Let's give it up for your hair.